Okay, your turn.
Well, my best friend, who lives in U.S.
is
because I'm with Lara.
You remember the guy?
He's a best friend. He's the biggest fan of Lara. How are you, Andy?
I'm good.
Okay.
I'm good.
So
feeling better now. Urvashi, you can take a seat right there. Yes, thank you. Please, Urvashi, share some thoughts about your journey with Miss Diva and how it has kind of impacted your journey till now. We would really like to know. I mean, everybody knows really,
yes,
but it's just nice to kind of hear it from the horse's mouth.
Okay.
So let's just hear it from you.
First of all, my journey has been really unique. It's been really very different because I entered Bollywood, then I came back here again. All I would say that superheroes wear capes, but some superheroes wear crown and heels. And the moment Lara made me wear the crown, I became a superhero. The very same day when I became Miss Diva, Miss Universe in the 2015, I became a superhero. So I'm just so very thankful to Times of India, Times Group, and Lara especially for grooming all of us, not only me, but all the contestants. She has been our rock, and I'm just so very grateful to have a mentor like Lara. And you are a very special person in my life. You even know that. So yeah, I mean, what else? I mean,
you can talk about me also. I'm just kidding.
I would just say,
why don't you talk about what happened at Miss Universe, in the sense, what was your experience? And why don't you tell us how your thought process after winning the pageant and after you went back to Bollywood changed? We would like to know that.
Well, when you're in the pageant, it's just like, you know, it's just like as if you're in a, you're going on for Olympics or you're training for Olympics. You really get to learn a lot, but being in a pageant, you really get to learn. You're like, you know, you perform your best under pressure. That's what you learn. You learn goal setting. You learn how to be the best version of yourself. I think that's what pageants teach you. Yeah.
Okay, a controversial one.
Oh my God.
Who were you really rooting for? Philippines or Colombia in your year? If it wasn't you, who were you rooting for?
Personally rooting for?
You know what I mean.
I would say Colombia, Ariadna.
Yeah. And why?
Why? Because for me, a winner should always be a complete package. She should be the best. Like, she should be a complete package with a great framework skills, with a great Q&A. And she should have a great personality, a great person from heart. That really matters to me the most.
Are you still in touch with her?
Yes, we FaceTime each other. Yeah.
Wow. So women can be friends.
You listen, yes, of course.
Yeah. Is that true? We all agree. Yeah.
I still have one of the most rewarding friendships in my life till date is with Miss Namibia. So Miss Namibia, Mia, Miss Japan, Mayu, and me. We were called the three peas in a pod during my year. And today, Mia and I both have a daughter each. We're still very good friends. We still go on holidays together. Mayu is an incredible lawyer in Japan. So I haven't seen Mayu in a few years. But these are friendships that lasted way over anybody winning a title or, you know, taking away a crown or anything like that. And they're amazing friendships that you make.
Wow, that really speaks volumes.
I completely agree with her. The friendships we have, you know, a fate like a WhatsApp group with all the countries all together, and then a lot of the girls, they're married, they have 2-3 babies. So I'm like, oh my God, they already have babies.
Already?
Yeah, exactly. Wow. That's quite hard to digest. I guess Miss Italy, she has like 2 babies
already. Yeah.
Wow, that's
amazing.
Really beautiful.
So, you know, I mean, you know, this whole thing that we revolve around that two beautiful women cannot be friends is like really untrue when it comes to this world, okay? Yes, there's a competition and all of that, but at the end of the day, it's all about being a great human being and cherish a lot of friendships. And guess what? They don't make regular friends. They make, like, you know, friends who represent other countries, which is quite cool, I must say. Thank you so much for sharing that. Thank you so much, Laura. Let me call upon our next lovely lady. And I mean, she is part of the family now, I suppose. I mean, she's our in-house grooming expert. All the women come to her for advice. Please help us. We want to be, you know, winning this just like you did it. She won us the Miss Supranational title, which was the first ever. She was the first Asian to win that title. And we are, come on, let's give it up, yeah? The first Asian to win that title. And you know, she was an NCC cadet. Actually, let me not even say regular, because regular girls don't go to law. They are tough women and they're there, and she never thought of wearing the heels and the aisles. And when we saw her the first day at the audition, we were stumped with her stumped catwalk, ramp walk.
See, but then this is where I'm shattering, including within the organization, this is where I'm shattering stereotypes. Please, a Miss Diva doesn't have to be born in heels and be a girly girl who only wants to, you know, wear tiaras on her head and pink dresses. I spent most of my childhood up in trees plucking whatever fruit I could get my hands off with my knees busted and my elbows busted. And I was an NCC cadet who went crawling through trenches with those awful 303 rifles over our heads at 5 o'clock in the morning.
Whoa!
I'm sorry, I disagree. That is what we're doing. We're rewriting the rules right here as Indian women.
I completely, completely agree with you.
You can mention about me as well. I'm also a national basketball champion.
Okay. These are tough women sitting there. You can't like compete with them, alright? I'm telling you, the guys here. Yeah. Go ahead, please stand up and ask your question. It'll be really nice.
Hi, Lara ma'am. My name is Dipti. I'm a fashion blogger and a law student. I would like to know what are the special efforts the contestants need to put in so that they win the Miss Universe contest this year? I mean, apart from winning Yamaha Casino Miss Diva Miss Universe 2017.
No, it's a good question. So, when I asked what was so special about Miss France this year, that's what I asked the Miss Universe people when I met them in New York. I said, what out of 100 and I don't know how many ever countries, what made France stand out? And the response that I got back is that the coordinators, so the countries are divided into small groups when you're participating at the pageant, and each group has a coordinator that looks after, say, 4 or 5 girls. So what I got the feedback was that the coordinators right across through the entire Miss Universe organization absolutely loved Miss France, even before she came in front of any judging panel, because she had a warmth and a sincerity that wasn't put on, it wasn't fake, it wasn't, you know, sort of made up. She was not a textbook beauty queen, you know, she wasn't saying the right things and dressing the right way and, you know, so she was genuinely warm and she was genuine, and that's the most important thing. So I think for us today, a lot of the times the girls have watched so many past contests, Sushmita's, Aishwarya's, Diana's, Priyanka's, mine, you know, that they come with a mindset that I must stand like this and I must speak like this, you know, and I must walk like that. And it honestly, for me, when I see that, it negates the possibility of how much I can do with the girl right there. Because I'd rather have a clean slate that I can start afresh with, you know, and make you understand the fact that being a beauty queen or being a Miss Diva goes so much more beyond just the way that you present yourself when the cameras are rolling or when the judges are sitting in front of you. You know, what is it that you are like as a person? So those are the things that we work on to instill a sense of confidence in themselves within the girls. The girls are very, very young. A lot of them don't have a lot of exposure. They come from small towns. So how do you give them a worldwide view? How do you give them the confidence and the courage to stand up and actually say something that may be controversial, maybe something that's not aligned with the majority way that the masses think? You know, how do you give someone that young the confidence to be able to do that? So those are the things that go into the training process. Those are the most important things. Apart from that, yes, we're teaching you to walk in heels, we're teaching you how to, you know, to converse, how to style yourself, how to dress, how to be presentable. But it goes so much, that's why I was saying that finally at the end of the day, these girls will take something that will last them a lifetime, far beyond what they will do at a contest.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, you're looking really pretty.
Thank you.
Okay, I just want to ask you one question. What do you think that apart from grooming and you know, giving them the poise that you're going to do for them?
I can't give them the poise. I can only help.
Okay, what do you think actually makes a diva in the truest sense?
That's what I said. That is, for me, the truest essence of a diva is exactly that. It's somebody who's totally and completely unapologetic and unafraid to be herself. That is a diva. Doesn't matter if she's a diva who's winning with a crown on her head or not. You are a diva to me in my eyes if that is who you are. If you own who you are, to me, that is a diva.
Thank you so much.
You're the diva of divas. We have to learn from you.
Thank you, Ms. Yeah. Just one moment, coming. One moment, please wait. Yes, you? Excuse me? Go ahead.
Hi. So, while Asha was talking and Aradhana was talking, I realized that both your parents have been really supportive. And, you know, when Lara, you were saying that in terms of the talent pool, there is talent diminishing every year. I think parental consent is a huge barrier, right? So, is there something that as the platform is Diva, you can do to kind of break that?
I think for me, being here and being associated with it is one of the key reasons that actually will provide, you know, sort of a reassurance and a comfort to a lot of, especially parents, guardians out there. The idea that we're saying is give us your daughters so that we may actually make something of them. And I'm an example of what the possibility could be. So for me as a celebrity, whether it's as a Miss Universe, as a Miss India, as an actor, there's a tremendous amount of social responsibility that comes with the way that I am projected, the things that I say, the way that I have constantly tried to conduct my life as, you know. So there is, I mean, at the end of the day, there's a lot of exploitation in the glamour world. There's a lot of exploitation, there's no getting away with that. And at some point of time, as an actress or as a beauty queen, some people that you may come, you know, in contact with will probably exploit you. But in these 3 or 4 weeks that I get with these girls, and these girls know, I mean, every time I get a moment alone with them, all I can possibly do is try and give them enough examples on how to protect themselves from those kind of situations arising. You know, so that is exactly what I'm there for. When I'm here as a mentor, that is my job. My job is not just to groom these girls, but also to protect them.
Thank you.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yes, Lisa.
Hello ladies, my name is Vikram. Actually, I have a question for Urvashi. First of all, you look very beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah, and I wanted to ask that, like, what was the feeling when you won Miss Diva and when you entered Miss Universe? Like, how did it change your life?
I'd say that I became a diva. As we all know, a diva is an intelligent, a beautiful, and an extremely ambitious woman who knows, who's really extremely good at what she does. And she really works hard a lot for everything she wants in life, and it also exemplifies class, grace, and your personality. So I think that is all what I learned being a diva and winning the title Miss Universe India.
Thank you.
Hello, Lara ma'am. My name is Nihanshma, and I want to ask a question. I believe that every contestant is different, but at some point of time in the past or in the future, have you come across any point that you see that two contestants are same and you're confused whom they actually select and you send it to finals?
It happens all the time. It happened just yesterday when we were doing the final auditions. It's so difficult. You'll find two girls who will be tied with exactly the same amount, the same points, and then you don't know because only one of them can make it.
So then what do you do?
You go with your gut. That's what they've hired me for. They've hired me for my eye and my gut. That's what I go with. No. I think... No, but you know, I'll tell you, because this is such a visual medium and it's all about first impressions. So I think if there are two girls, you have to veer towards the girl that has the most maximum stage presence at that point of time. Because at the end of the day, at an international contest, the judges very rarely will see you up close and personal. The most of the time, they're seeing you right on stage. So it's about the kind of effect that you have and the impact that you have, what you exude when you're standing there. So most of the time, it'll boil down to that.
You said that you were first in Bollywood, then you got into the modeling industry, and then you again went back.
No.
Yeah, I think you mentioned earlier, the first statement.
First, Miss Teen India, my other passion is modeling as well.
No, you did some work in Bollywood, somewhere, some... I had read about some article also. Yeah, some article also. So, has this thing of industry done this universe thing has changed everything in Bollywood, your presence in Bollywood?
Actually, this was more of an internal reason.
Yes.
I think
no,
that...
No, I'm not talking about that. Like your confidence or something has changed.
No, I was always confident since day one.
Okay.
But it's just like... okay,
please correct me if I'm wrong. What she's asking you is, how after you came to Yama Casino, Miss Diva, your life changed in Bollywood.
Yeah.
Did it change in Bollywood? Did your thought process change in Bollywood? Do you think it really impacted you winning Yama Casino Miss Diva in Bollywood, or was it just the regular back entry into the industry?
Of course it does.
Yeah, go ahead, please. Take this one.
Hello, yes.
Being Miss Universe,
which
I won.
Exactly. So, I mean, I don't know how to ask you that thing. Like, you must have thought somewhere to be in Bollywood someday.
The Bollywood never.
Endorsing something or, you know, being able to friends or something.
Miss, winning Miss Universe at your
office. Okay, that was a thing.
Remind you for your journey and it's the same right.
Yes,
now.
It reminds me of my journey. All I'd like to say is that this moment will always remain very special in my heart. And as they say that, you know, superheroes wear cape. There are a lot of superheroes who wear heels and crown as well. So the moment I won my Miss Universe India crown, I became a superhero. बहुत अच्छा लगता है और I just like to wish all the girls all the very best. You know, participating in a beauty pageant is just like participating in any kind of sports activity. तो जो आप स्पोर्ट्स से सीखते हैं, यानी कि you know being confident under pressure as well. So that's what you learn from beauty pageants. So I just like to wish all of them all the very best.
What were the challenges you were facing at your time?
Challenges I was facing at my time was well, there are challenges for everybody. But I'm just so thankful that that I'm just so grateful to God, to everybody who has supported me throughout every single thing that I won Miss Universe India twice. So. Yeah, it's a great honor for me.
Anything you want to say
for the contestants? Do your best, forget the rest, and just be the best version of yourself. That's what I like to say.
And you also signed a new woman-centered movie with a coffee with the director.
Uh-huh.
And, yeah, it's Navidha Raj, and a co-star is Rajesh Sharma. Is that true?
No.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
I think मैं चार साल से Yamaha Casino Miss Diva के साथ जुड़ी हुई हूँ और मेरे लिए हर साल बहुत ही exciting रहता है. ये सबसे exciting time है actually जो हर साल की contest की शुरुआत है. क्योंकि मुझे एक पूरी नई बैच मिलती है, नई लड़कियाँ मिलती हैं जिसे मैं ग्रूम और ट्रेन करती हूँ. और जैसे आपने कहा, बहुत सारे मेमोरीज वापस आ जाते हैं क्योंकि 17 साल पहले मैं उन्हीं की जैसे थी. थोड़ी सी मेरे पास थोड़ा सा एक्सपीरियंस था क्योंकि मैं मॉडल रह चुकी थी, लेकिन फिर भी जो पैजेंट की जो दुनिया है वो बहुत अलग है. और अगर आपको एक मौका मिले कि आप मिस इंडिया जीते या मिस यूनिवर्स बने, तो आपकी पूरी ज़िंदगी बदल जाती है. तो आज जब मैं इन लड़कियों को सुनती हूँ, उनके एक्सपीरियंसेस को सुनती हूँ, तो बहुत सारी ऐसी चीज़ें याद आ जाती हैं जहाँ पर मैं भी बहुत नर्वस थी, कुछ चीज़ों के बारे में पता ही नहीं चला था तब उस वक्त. But you learn as you go along, and it's an incredible journey.
How does it feel being a mentor?
It's a big responsibility being a mentor. And you heard today, you've had a lot of information that's been made available about the contest. I've always said that for me, it's a big social responsibility because I have a lot of young women who look up to me, who emulate me, you know, who always say, we want to be just like you. That's a huge responsibility to have. But like I said, I always try and impart as much as I can to them in as little as a time as I'm allowed. We had a great training program when we participated at that time at Femina Miss India, but we didn't have any mentors. You know, Sushmita had one, so she came in and she spoke to us, but that was just a talk that we had. So we never had access on a day-to-day basis to somebody who had already won an international pageant and gone through that experience. So for us, I mean, the girls are very lucky today, really, to have the opportunity to have me around them for 3 weeks or 4 weeks, the time that we filmed this, because like I said, as much experience as I've gained, not just as in a year as Miss Universe, but over 17 years of experience, is something that I'm trying to put forward to them in a nutshell in 3 or 4 weeks. I see that the pool of girls that we're getting slowly over the years has gotten smaller. It's very difficult to find girls today who don't automatically want to first go to Bollywood, you know, who are willing to give an international pageant a try. So a lot fewer girls are willing to put themselves out there. I feel that they have the confidence to do that. And, you know, I want to tell them that it's an incredible opportunity. So we would love to have you. We would love to have girls who are intelligent, who are well-spoken. Beauty, you know, anybody who comes to enter in a beauty pageant, 90% of the girls are very pretty-looking girls. So we're not saying that the beautiful girls are less. What we're really saying is that the girls who have that confidence in themselves, that's getting less every year. I think one key thing, if you're going to come and be part of this, is that you have to submit yourself to this process. You have to have a really open mind. You have to be ready to say, there are a lot of things that I don't know about. There are a lot of experiences that I haven't had, but I'm ready for them. And when you allow yourself to become open like that as a person, then you're ready for anything that comes your way and you really excel in it. You give it everything that you've got. Beauty icon and inspiration. In Bollywood, I think for me, you know, growing up in Bangalore, I didn't watch a lot of, you know, the recent movies, as in recent, I'm not talking about now, I'm talking about when I was a kid. I didn't watch the new movies. We watched a lot of the older films. So for me, you know, actresses like Saira Banu were stunning, were gorgeous. They had, you know, in the olden days, the makeup was different. They wore a lot of wigs and things like that, but they had a grace and a class. Nargis had a grace and a class that was incomparable. And those are the things that I thought I wanted to emulate as an actress. I didn't want to follow the latest fashion or wear the correct eyeliner or, you know, be dressed by the in designer. It was about exuding a certain kind of a grace, a certain kind of a charm that lasted generations and not just the time that you spent in the time span of your career.
जैसे अभी आपने कहा कि सैरा बानू इज़ अ नेशनल ब्यूटी.
जी
जी. इफ यू गेट अ चांस टू डू अ बायोपिक ऑफ हर, वुड यू डू?
ओह, इंशाल्लाह, इफ आई एम ऑफर्ड अ बायोपिक, व्हाई नॉट, बट आई थिंक दोस वुड बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट एंड हार्ड शूज टू फिल. All my messages, you'll have to come and watch Femina, you'll have to watch Yamaha Fasino Miss Diva. I will give you all the messages you need, what it takes to be a model or a pageant winner right there.
Last question. आज के टाइम पे ज़्यादा करके वो पापराजीज़ में स्पॉटेड किए जाते हैं, वक्त से पहले सेलिब्रिटी बन जाना, किस तरह से आपको ये सही लगता है? आप कभी इस तरह से अपनी डॉटर के साथ कभी स्पॉटेड नहीं की गई हैं, ये आपको सही लगता है जैसे ये वक्त से पहले सेलिब्रिटी बन जाना, उनको कैमरे के सामने लाना?
ऑनेस्टली मैं इन चीज़ों के बारे में ज़्यादा सोचती नहीं हूँ. लाइफ इज़ ऑर्गेनिक. मैंने अपनी बेटी की परवरिश वैसे की है जो मुझे लगा है, दैट्स द वे दैट आई वॉन्टेड टू रेज हर. और मैंने कभी ऐसे फेस नहीं किया है कि पापराजी मेरे सामने आकर अपना कैमरा डाल दे. वेन एवर आई हैव मेट द मीडिया और द पापराजी, अगर मैंने उन्हें रिक्वेस्ट किया है कि आप मेरी पिक्चर ले लो लेकिन मेरी बेटी को एक्सक्यूज करें, दे हैव ऑलवेज लिसन टू मी. तो आई हैव नेवर हैड अ बैड एक्सपीरियंस वेयर दे हैव नॉट लिसन टू मी एंड अटैक माई चाइल्ड और बीन व्हाटएवर. तो आई थिंक इट्स अ गिव एंड टेक रिलेशनशिप. मुझे पता है कि मेरी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी एज अ सेलिब्रिटी क्या है. कभी ऐसा भी होता है कि टुडे इफ माई डॉटर डजेंट माइंड इट, अगर वो खुश है, हर एक्सप्रेशन इज ऑल राइट, यू नो शी डजेंट, शी इज़ नॉट फेस्ड बाई इट, तो आई डोंट हैव अ प्रॉब्लम विद इट. बट इफ माई डॉटर इज स्केयर्ड बाई वॉट शी सिंग, आई विल प्रोटेक्ट हर, दैट्स अ मदरली इंस्टिंक्ट. एंड आई थिंक हमारे देश में जो मीडिया है, जो पापराजी है, वो थोड़ी अमेरिकन पापराजी के कल्चर से थोड़ी सी अलग है. सो दे रियली अंडरस्टैंड वे इफ यू रिक्वेस्ट कि माई यू आर फ्राइटिंग द चाइल्ड, डोंट डू इट, दे रियली लिसन एंड आई एम ग्रेटफुल फॉर दैट. थैंक यू
सो मच.
थैंक यू.